Welcome to the most useful haul you'll ever see, because this color palette is something that is वैसे तो in trend but is evergreen. These clothes you can style forever as long as you can make them last in your wardrobe. I'm going to show you n number of ways how you can style and master the nude color palette. For the first outfit, I wanted to put together something very chic out there but 100% wearable. The main piece of this outfit was the pair of bottoms, because they have a very interesting fold at the waistline. To highlight the waistline, the top needed to be cropped. So what better than going little cream on the whiter side? This particular top, which has stripes in different shades of brown and a little bit of dull blue too. The thing with nude slash brown color palette is that you don't necessarily have to go all brown, because it can become an overkill. So this outfit in itself is quite striking but almost fully covered, so there's not much you need to be worried about. Now with a top like this, I prefer highlighting the neckline with the necklace, because it will bring more attention to the neckline. Since I want to leave my hair open in this outfit, I have put very small golden hoops. Now with the footwear, since there's already so much going on with the clothing itself, I wanted to keep it as basic as possible. Hence I went with white sandals, wear very very tiny heel, and the upper is transparent, so it does not add to the outfit at all. As for the bag, because the pants are quite baggy, I wanted to keep a tote bag to match the silhouette of the pant. So in itself, the outfit is very structured because it is tight at the waist. So this is an outfit I could wear in the blink of an eye. For the second look, I wanted to bring back a piece of clothing which has been so undermined. Those are cargo pants, but in a khaki sort of color, which also falls in the brown color palette for me. These add so much character because they instantly make a sporty casual vibe to an outfit. With this, I paired a very fitted tank top, which also has some brown burgundy elements on the hems. Cargos are slightly loose from the knee till the calf. It does bring the outfit together because the tank top is super, super fitted. Personally, I love pairing chunky sneakers with things which are tapering at the bottom, because that, I think, balances out the whole shape of the outfit. Now, because I was going for a sporty vibe, I backpack, which is like a proper fashion backpack, isme zyada kuch saman fit nahi aayega. When I wear any high neck top, I refrain from usually wearing necklaces unless they're like going to be very visible through the top. I wore these tiny earrings. This is one of my favorite easily everyday wearable look. If you feel uncomfortable in wearing sleeveless clothes, you can easily switch it out for a full sleeve. It's very very comfortable, probably the most comfortable outfit through and through. Outfit 3 may just be the most easy breezy look, because it's just a one clothing item outfit. Now this one, a proper nude brown color, it has a little bit of a deep neck, but I don't think the cleavage is starting to show. To pair up with this, I wore combat boots in the same brown color. They do look very good with this because there's a lot of attention that they're getting. Now the main element that I thought would be a steal deal in this is the bag. As for jewelry, whenever there's something so muted, you can go loud with jewelry. So I wore a very chunky necklace chain. For earrings, I just kept the same tiny but chunky hoops. This is very very comfortable and you can wear it anywhere you go, for a cafe, for a day out. Outfit 4, this would be an outfit jo agar main kisi aur ko pehnte hue dekhti to main intimidate ho jati thi ki wow. The key is all in neutrals, and how could I leave Indian out of this special video? Both the elements of this outfit are completely solid. There's no print on it. The kurta is a cotton beige color kurta. The pants are a satin material, and coming to how to jazz it up and make it a chic outfit, I put the hair up so that there's only the fringe coming forward and the rest is like in a cute romantic low bun. Now to tie that, I used satin scrunchie again to match with the leggings. Simple kurtas like this, I always love to wear like a big necklace because it adds to the outfit and takes it from simple to another level. Chose another neutral element, but this has a jazz sass to it because it's sparkly and it's a marble finish bag. And to match with the marble in the bag, I went for marble wale flats. ये सारे जो अपने बंजारन और एकदम हटके वाले जो elements होते हैं ना यार, वो branded है online में ना थोड़ा difficult होता है, but I will try my best to link these items for you. Outfit number 5, I know you've seen this before. Back then हमने खरीदा था ये सोच के एक night suit बनेगा, but to be honest, I've actually worn this more outside than inside. It's a very sophisticated looking outfit, but comfort is on another level because the shorts are actually pretty long. I do feel very comfortable in going out in this particular length, and baki bhi it's quite modest on the top. As promised, this video is going to be for everybody's comfort zone. I will link full pant wale neutral color palette wale coordinate sets in the description box. This honestly you can style up any way. I have kept it as authentic as possible except the makeup part. And I usually have my backpack which is much bigger. वो इतनी बड़ी backpack है कि उसमें laptop, hard drives, extra कपड़े सब मैं लेके निकलती हूँ, क्योंकि मैं कभी भी मेरे friends के घर पे चले जाती हूँ रहने. Any चप्पल, any slipper is also cool. This is not a fashion outfit. But if you want to make it look like you put effort without putting the effort, then this is the outfit for you. Outfit number 6 is my go-to, what I've been wearing almost every single day. You're a part of Instagram family, you know. Now, why I picked this for this video is to explain that a neutral outfit does not necessarily have to be solid. It can definitely have pattern, especially something as colorful as this. For me, it still comes under the neutral color palette. It's a very spring type outfit, which is a very refreshing fit, especially matching with the cut of this with a lot of frills here and there. This I style particularly with very, very simple things, because on a day-to-day basis, I don't wear that many accessories. I just put earrings, even though we could put a dainty necklace as this has a V-neck. As for footwear, I went for flats, which do have a brown theme dominantly, but they also have some gemstones which match the floral print in the dress. As for the bag, I just paired a nude colored sling bag with this because it's so casual. That's where I would wear this outfit. And that's how you can style it too for another day out. Now, outfit 7 is my take on formal wear, but in the neutral color palette. I bought these trousers around my birthday, and they're a pair of skinny trousers. So this allowed me to bring some volume on the up top with the shirt. What this does is it adds a very crisp look to the whole thing. I literally went from the last look to this in 2 minutes, and I feel the major takeaway was the hairdo. कभी भी कोई ऐसे formal काम पे जाता है ना, it's best to keep things as readily available to you as possible. So tying low ponytail with a partition is my go-to formal hairstyle. And as for the accessories, I wore the smallest golden earrings I could find. For the bag, I chose this black bag, which is out of shape right now. Usually, ऐसे bags को stuff करके रखना चाहिए. I wore black block heels with it, which have a pointed toe and a sling at the back. Now, this for me is the epitome of sexy. I've truly enjoyed wearing them after I've accepted my body for what it is. It just is very hot. That's the only word that comes to my mind every time I put it on. And if you're not comfortable wearing sleeveless, I'll find full sleeve options too. Or you can also wear an overshirt like this one. To balance out the brown, I wore white strappy heels with it, which looks good. Like the crisscross at the front adds to the teamy factor. The most trendy bag of all, a baguette bag. This one particularly isn't a baguette bag, it's more like a shoulder bag, which has an adjustable strap too in case you want to make it a sling. This is my definition of like a very love yourself, feel great outfit. Let's move on to the next one. Second last outfit already, and I've not had this much fun making a fashion video. This outfit is mainly dedicated to the bottoms. Basically, I just want to show you that how adding any one white element, especially if it's such an important one as a bottom, can neutralize the whole outfit and make it a top-notch one, because everything except the skirt is in the brown tone, but it's still not becoming an overkill. For example, I'm wearing these root hoops, which are brown in color, a brown sweater, a macrame belt bag, which is very adorable, a very kind brand sent it, but without a note. So I don't know who exactly sent it, a very ingenious concept. So you could tie this to your denim as well. This skirt is white, almost an off-white, but still in the white, not in the browns at all. And I'm wearing brown heels, but still it's tied the whole thing together, and that credit goes to this one white element. Now, outfit number 10 had to be the showstopper and the true merge of both cultures that we do follow the most in India for dressing up. This is my take on an Indo-Western outfit. Element that made me think in this direction was the pant. Flowy pants are usually very accommodating in general, so I thought I'd pair it with a white crop top, which has a V-neck that can make space for a nice boho silver necklace. And usually I refrain from wearing loud earrings and loud necklace, but this look called for it honestly. Now, if you're not comfortable wearing sleeveless crop tops like this, I have a solution for you, which I myself recently found, which are detachable sleeves. I saw it with Sakshi Shivdasani, and these sleeves cost me 900 rupees per pair, which is quite affordable. So they also have full sleeves and half sleeves both. Paired this with the mojris because they're very easy to slide on and carry. They're also beige in color. And to top it off, finally, I have this envelope bag. The jute in the bag complements the texture of the pants very well, and the silver coin work, whole look is such a beautiful amalgamation of everything. The prettiest out of all, I feel. But I'm so happy to finally begin this. I don't know if this will be a series, but at least mujhe kab se pyaas lagi thi ki main acha ekdam tagda fashion ke upar kuch video banau, which is a haul, come styling tips, come lookbook, everything, all the knowledge that I have and every way possible that I can help you, packaged into one. Help me pick a name for this in in case we want to make it a series and you only let me know if you want this to become a series, तो अगला टॉपिक हम क्या उठाए. फॉर एग्जाम्पल इस एपिसोड का पूरा थीम था न्यूट्रल कलर पैलेट, न्यूट कलर्स, बेज कलर्स, हाउ टू स्टाइल दोज एंड हाउ टू फाइंड अ वे टू मेक एवरी आउटफिट एंड एवरी सिलवट कम्फर्टेबल. बट इफ यू डिड एंजॉय दिस वीडियो और आपको अगर जरा सी भी हेल्प हुई होगी तो डू गिव इट अ थम्स अप एंड सब्सक्राइब टू आवर चैनल. एंड इफ यू डिड नॉट एंजॉय वॉचिंग दिस वीडियो बिंदास गिव अ थम्स डाउन. आई विल सी यू इन अ ब्रांड न्यू वीडियो वेरी वेरी सून. Until then, goodbye.